Pinagpalang araw po para sa ating lahat, sa ating po mga nakikinig at taga-subaybay ng Snack Break Time Cheers mula po sa iba't ibang bahagi ng mundo. Purihin po ang Panginoon Diyos at lagi po namin kayo nakakasama. And if this is your first time to join us, may I request na sana po ay mag-ano po kayo ng inyo pong subscribe button at i-like nyo po ang ating pong mga episodes dito at naway sundan din po ninyo yung mga nakaraan pong mga usapin. Now, actually, sa ngayon po, ang amin pong pinag-aaralan ay ang ting Rediscovering the Manual for Success. Bakit po importante po ito? Kasi ho, kung napansin po natin, we are now entering into a new normal. Ang mga bagay-bagay po ay bagong-bago ho lahat. No? We don't even know exactly anong mga mangyayari sa mga dating na araw, anong klaseng adjustments ang ating mga gagawin. But sa kahit anong bagay, let's go back to the manual of life. Kaya ho, ang ating tagumpay ay lagi nakabatay po sa manual ho natin. Kaya ho, nakita natin sa nakaraating pag-aaral, may manual ang sasakyan. Kapag mayroong mga bagay na problema, we need to look at the how to troubleshoot, how to maintain, how to, for in case of emergency, what needs to be done. Nandun po lahat yon. And surprisingly, ganun din po sa buhay. Kaya nga po, nakita natin yan, nung nagsimula ho sila David, nagsimula ho sila Joshua, nagsimula ho sila Ezra, as some of the examples that we studied, nakita ho natin from nothing, from the dark past, ay talagang nakabawi sila by going back to the very manual of life. Kaya ho, nandoon din ho yung manual ng success because yung success is not necessarily yung pong naiisip ng maraming tao na kapag yumaman ka, successful ka. Pero ang totoo niyan is yung success, yung tama yung pagkakagamit ng isang bagay. Halimbawa, kung ito ay isang gamit manufactured by a certain company and the very purpose of that particular gamit talaga nasuserve, yun ang tagumpay. Kung hindi niya nasuserve yung purpose niya, di sayang din. For example, kung yung telepono nung nabili mo, kahit ang napakamahal, napakaganda, pero kung hindi mo magamit pantawag, hindi mo magamit to connect with people, to communicate, hindi niya nasuserve yung purpose niya, then hindi siya matagumpay na gadget. So ganun din ho sa ating buhay. Kaya ho, napansin po ninyo, sa ating pong manual, ang tanong, ano yung manual na gagamitin natin? Siyempre, kung anong ginamit ni Joshua, anong ginamit ni David, anong ginamit ni Ezra, yun ang ating tinitingnan at pinapansin. Bakit yun ang ginamit nila? Diba? Sa kasaysayan, bakit yun ang kailang sinubaybayan? Kaya gayon din po sa ating ngayon, may I encourage you, of all the books sa kasaysayan ng tao, ito lang po yung aklat na napaka-unique. And napag-aralan natin yan. Unique in terms of its circulation, unique in terms of its translation, unique in terms of its survival, unique in terms of its unity. Bakit? Ito po ay composed of different books, pero para silang iisang aklat because they were saying the same thing. Kahit magkakaiba po ang pinanggalingan nila, kahit magkakaiba po ang kanilang parang panahon ng pagkakasulat, and yet they were just saying one theme. Kaya ho, sa ating pong pag-aaral na karaan, if you want to understand real success, let's always go back to what? Purpose. Ganun din sa ating pagbabasa. When you read a book, yung title itself will give you a clue of its purpose. Ngayon, kung hindi mo naman maliwanagan doon, as you read, the first thing that you need to understand when you are reading any book, you need to understand yung purpose. Kaya ho, yung Bible, among all the other books, ito po yung nagturo ng simula at hangganan ng tao. And sa lahat, yun po yung pinaka-logical na pagkakasaad ng ating kasaysayan. Unlike the other books, ang dami mo pang parang it takes a lot of faith and talagang ang hirap. But this one, it is very clear. Even the very problems of human beings, makita nyo, napaka-clear nandoon. And no wonder, kaya pala nangyayari ito. The moment na nasimula mong basahin, maintindihan mo little by little kung paano nangyayari yon at paintindihan mo anong nangyayari sa katauhan. Kaya ho, yun din ang aking mungkahi sa inyo. Now, as I've said yesterday, sabi natin, we need to have a clear understanding of the purpose. Kasi kung walang purpose, wala kang dahilan para masabi ikay nagtagumpay. And if you have just evolved and you would not listen to the manual of life that we are created beings, then purpose is not an issue. Bakit? Aksidente lang tayo if we are not created. But if we are created, then the Creator has a purpose for us. And no wonder, magkakaiba itsura natin, magkakaiba ang taas natin, magkakaiba lakas natin, magkakaiba galing natin, because everyone will serve an individual and unique purpose. Kaya ho, yun ang napaka-importante nating makita. Now, ito ho, paano natin ito babasahin? Yan ang malaking pagtatalo. Paano ba ito binabasa? Now, Katulad din ng mga aklat, you have to read it kung ano yung genre niya. For example, kung ang genre niyan poetic, din poem yan, di basahin mo siya as a poem. Ngayon, kapag yan ay prose, basahin mo siya as a prose. Pag yan ay history, basahin mo siya as history. Kaya, kapag yan ay apocalyptic, basahin mo siya as apocalyptic. So, hindi mo kailangan guluhin ang utak mo. Ngayon, pangalawa, itong malaking problema. Imagine, they were just compiled into one book. But different books yan. So, pag binasa ko yan, kung kanyari sakali lang during that time, going back to its history, yun lang isang aklat ang aking babasahin, would be suffice or sufficient to serve its purpose as a book, di ba? Kaya nakita ho natin yun, importante. Bigyan ko yung sample. For example, ang Luke, why was Luke written? Sabi ng mismong author, sabi niya, inasmuch as many have been undertaken to compile an account of the things accomplished among us, just as they were handed down to us by those who from the beginning were eyewitnesses and servants of the word. So sabi niya, it seemed fitting for me as well, having investigated everything carefully from the beginning, to write it out to you in consecutive order, most excellent Theophilus. So ang liwanag kagad that if this was written for excellent Theophilus, I don't know why, but perhaps the very reason is just to give him as consecutive order of what had transpired in the life of Jesus Christ. Kasi mayroon pong pangyayari at that time that people were just confused, but people were really surprised and they were talking about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Kaya naman sabi niya, the eyewitnesses, ito, dami ng kinalat na sinulat, but I would want it to be a more objective and investigate the consecutive order. So may purpose siya. So more or less, maintindihan mo, kaya pala ito sinulat. And who is Theophilus? At least mayroon ka ng reference point of where to research and who Theophilus is. Pero hindi pa natin pag-uusapan ngayon yan. I'm just telling you, ganyan magbasa. Tingnan mo kaagad yung purpose. Kaya pag binabasa mo, maintindihan mo yung purpose niya at maintindihan mo why that particular text was said that way. Kasi nga, a text without a context is a pretext. Sa Tagalog, ang tekstong wala sa konteksto ay hindi talaga teksto. Hindi talaga yun ang sinasabi niya. Kaya ho, maraming problema ng tao, ginagamit yung aklat, they will jump from one book to another, tapos malilito na sila kasi they can prove anything. Kaya ho, napaka-importante, ano ba yung pinag-uusapan dito? And if ever you will quote somebody else or some other parts of the books, it only confirms but it does not explain. Are you following? Now let's continue. For example, ang John, he also gave a very clear reason. Sabi niya, therefore, many other signs Jesus also performed in the presence of the disciples which are not written in this book. So, liwa-liwanag na, that particular alone. But this have been written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in His name. O anong purpose niya? He wants us to have life. In His name, He wants to prove to us that Jesus is the Son of God. He is the Christ. So, yun yung pinakalayunin. Ibig sabihin, that book alone, he was hoping na yung magbabasa, makikilala niya si Jesus as the Christ, the Son of God, and by believing in Him, they will find life. Now, ganun din naman si Paul when he wrote, for example, Romans. Sabi niya ganun, so on my part, I'm eager to preach the gospel to you who are also in Rome. For I am not ashamed of the gospel. It is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes, and to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. For in it the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the righteous shall live by faith. So, sa ibang mga aklat, hindi klaro yung pinaka-purpose, but as you read it, maka-clarify mo, siguro kaya ito ganito sinulat niya kasi ito yung gusto niyang palabas. Yung maraming ulit na sinasabi, paulit-ulit niyang binabanggit, hindi nakikita mo, nagkakaroon ka ng hint, this is now why he was writing this. Ganon din naman ang Bible. Meron din po rin siyang, yung kabuuan niya, meron din maliwanag na purpose. And here I will end for the meantime. Ano sabi niya? Una na, tinanong si Jesus sa isang lawyer. Sabi ng lawyer, ikaw na, Lord, sabi niya, which is the great commandment in the law? Ano ba ang pinakadakilang commandment? And look at the answer of Jesus Christ. Sabi niya, this is the first and foremost commandment. Ano yun? You shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your mind. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. Now look at the words. On these two commandments depend the whole law and the prophets. Ano siya sabi ni God? Yung pinaka-idea ng lahat ng sulatin na ito is for us to have the right relationship with God, which is to love Him with all of our heart, soul, and mind. And because of that relationship, it will be translated in a proper relationship with our neighbor. Kaya nga, loving our neighbor as we love ourselves. So, pag ang basa mo ng Bible, babasahin mo para to debate with other people to prove that you know better, o kaya naman ang para makipagtalo ka, then you miss the point. Obviously, you're reading it wrongly. Dapat, ang effect sa atin, when we read it, we are to love God more, we have to have the right relationship with Him, and we are to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Itutuloy po natin ang usapin na ito bukas. But for the meantime, kung magbabasa ka, tingnan mo muna, am I loving God with all of this? Or am I also becoming more loving towards others? Yan muna ang ating pong ilagay sa isip natin. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. At bukas away, magkita-kita tayo ulit para ipagpatuloy natin paano tayo babasahin ang Bible.